Hello friends, my name is Alissa and I'm the Science Program Manager at Boston Children's Museum. And today we're going to do a kitchen science activity called lava lamps. Lava lamps were invented in the early 1960s and were popular through the mid-1970s. They're filled with water and a mix of certain oils and waxes. When the lamp's bulb heats up the oil mixture, it floats and sometimes breaks up into different pieces. Then as it cools, it sinks back down. This pattern repeats itself, resulting in this groovy mixture you see here. Lava lamps didn't actually give off very good light. Instead, they were meant to be decorative. The lava lamps we'll be making today have different stuff inside, but the effect will be pretty similar. It's far out. Here's the things that you'll need for today's activity. Some water, vegetable oil, food coloring, Alka-Seltzer tablets, an empty bottle like this one, or if you don't have one, you can just use a glass. Whatever you have is fine as long as it's clear. And a funnel is helpful for pouring things. You also might want a flashlight, but if you don't have one, that's okay. Start by filling your container with a couple inches of water. Then, fill it the rest of the way with oil, or so that you have at least twice as much oil as you have water. Let your container sit for a while so the bubbles all settle out. What do you notice about the way the oil and the water are in this container? Is this what you expected to happen? After you've let everything set out, put in a few drops of food coloring. Notice what happens as the food coloring moves through the oil. Whoa. The food coloring has fallen through the oil and is now mixing with the water. Take an Alka-Seltzer tablet and break it up into a few pieces. Drop one in. What do you think will happen? Once the reaction has stopped, if you want to try it again, just drop in some more Alka-Seltzer. And if you really want to get that lava lamp effect, try holding a flashlight under it. You can keep playing with your lava lamp over and over. I could do this all day, but unfortunately, I have some other work to do. Thanks for joining me with Kitchen Science today. And don't forget to keep checking back on Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube for more cool activities you can try at home. Thanks for joining me today, and I'll see you next time.